In this video, we're going to learn about IOLink. What is IOLink, I hear you say? Well, listen closely and you'll find out. At RealParse, we love helping you learn. So if you enjoy this video as much as we enjoyed making it, click the like button. Subscribe and click the bell, and you'll receive notifications of new RealParse videos. So you'll never miss another one. IOLink is a communications protocol that works point-to-point. A point-to-point communication connection is a communications connection between two separate endpoints or nodes. IOLink is bi-directional, meaning it works two ways, and works over a short distance. It is primarily used to communicate with sensors and actuators in plant or factory automation processes. Sensors and actuators are usually connected via Fieldbus connections, allowing them to be in remote locations. With IOLink, the field devices, such as actuators or sensors, connect to a master device, which communicates to a controller, usually a PLC or programmable logic controller. The connection between the IOLink master and the field device is established via an unscreened three-wire cable, no more than 20 meters long. The IOLink master is capable of processing digital signals and analog values. Its versatility means it is capable of integrating into existing systems and can communicate using the industry-recognized Profinet, Profibus, or Modbus, to name a few. The IOLink master establishes the connection between the IOLink devices and the automation system. As a component of an I/O system, the IOLink master is installed either in the control cabinet or as remote I/O, directly in the field. An IOLink master can have several IOLink ports or channels. An IOLink device can be connected to each port, meaning IOLink is a point-to-point communication and not a field bus. The IOLink protocol allows an IOLink port to be operated in one of four different operating modes. The first mode is the IOLink mode. This means that the port is used for IOLink communication. The second mode is the DI mode. This means that the port acts in the same way as a digital input device. The third mode is the DQ mode. This means that the port acts in the same way as a digital output device. The fourth mode is deactivated. This means that the port is not assigned to any other modes and is reserved for when the port is unused. IOLink is a very robust communication system that operates using 24 volts. Transmission errors can occur for a number of reasons. In general, a cable fault or a power surge can temporarily interfere with transmissions. If an error is detected, the message attempts transmission up to an additional two times. Only after the transmission has failed for a third time does the IOLink master recognize a communication failure. Upon recognizing this, the IOLink master will signal the communications failure to the higher-level controller. This can then alert operators or maintenance staff of the issue, so they can physically attend to and rectify the problem. An IOLink device has four types of transmission: process data, value status, device data, and events. The process data is considered as the latest state of the sensor or actuator, such as speed. Process data is transmitted cyclically, which means automatically, at regular defined intervals. Up to 32 bytes of process data can be processed, and it's defined by the high-level controller. The value status indicates whether the process data is valid or invalid, and is transmitted along with the process data cyclically. The device data holds detailed information about a device. Basic information, such as the serial number or version number, and more advanced information, such as parameters or diagnostic information, are able to be retrieved from each IOLink device. Device data is transmitted acyclically, at the request of the IOLink master. This means that it is not automatically transmitted, but will be transmitted after a request from the IOLink master. Device data can be read from the device, but also written too. A device is able to trigger an event, which in turn signals the presence of an event to the IOLink master. An example of an event is an error or warning message. For example, a short circuit, or a device that is overheating. This information can be used to display indicators or messages on HMI devices, such as error messages signaling a wire break or a communication failure, once the IOLink master has processed the message to the high-level controller. The transmission of device parameters and events occurs independently from the cyclic transmission of process data. This means that they do not impact each other, so critical messages do not have to queue until already buffered messages are sent. So let's try and summarize what we've learned today. IOLink is a simple communications protocol. It is used primarily for communications to simple three-wire sensors and actuators. An IOLink master has slave devices, such as an actuator or sensor, attached to it. The IOLink master can then communicate over a Fieldbus connection to the higher-level controller, most likely in our case, a PLC, or Programmable Logic Controller. The IOLink ports can serve different purposes, from signaling that it is unused to signal that it is in input mode, output mode, or for IOLink communication. An IOLink device transmits process data and value status periodically at a regular defined interval. This is called cyclic transmission. Device data, such as diagnostics and events, are transmitted when they are needed. This is called acyclic transmission. That's it for this video. I hope you've enjoyed learning about IOLink. It's a very simple communications protocol that can be quite complex to learn about. Getting the setup of the IOLink configuration correct is heavily dependent on the device it is being communicated with. So checking the field device's instructions is a necessity to be able to communicate correctly. Don't worry though, once it's set up, they are very easy to maintain, and often work seamlessly with no additional work required. Want to learn PLC programming in an easy-to-understand format and take your career to the next level? Head on over to realpars.com.